Very good afternoon to all. Today I'll be presenting on the immunogenicity and safety data of biologically vaccines PI-CRM197 typhoid conjugate vaccine in a multicenter randomized controlled clinical trial. Biologically is a vaccine manufacturing company and I work as a medical office manager. Regarding typhoid fever, if you look at the graph, the dark blue, the Indian subcontinent has the highest, incidence of typhoid fever, and out of 22 million cases, almost Indian subcontinent accounts more than 60% of the cases. And children are not only at the increased risk of infection, but also if you look at the third graph, they are also at increased risk of morbidity and mortality. And increasing resistance of increasing multi-drug resistance is complicating the treatment, and currently the safe and effective vaccines in our age group is the need of the hour. And if you look at the typhoid vaccines, currently typhoid conjugate vaccines are the major vaccines, and here typhoid VA polysaccharide is covalently linked to a carrier protein either TT, TD or CRM. So advantage of this is they create T cell dependent immune response, which are also effective in children less than 2 years, and the response creates memory which is boostable, and also it creates long lasting immunity with better efficacy. So because of this, so both WHO and IAP recommends the programmatic use of TCV as a preferred choice of typhoid vaccine in all age groups starting from 6 months of age. And regarding BE vaccine, so it contains 25 microgram of VA polysaccharide conjugated to 16 to 100 microgram of CRM197 and 2 phenoxyethanol as a preservative. And the vaccine meets the criteria set by the IAP monograph and WHO. And regarding the specialty of this vaccine is the first vaccine to use CRM197 as a conjugate protein, which is a better alternative for TT. Why we have selected CRM197 as a conjugate protein? Because this protein is well characterized and it can be highly purified with the purity of more than 98%, whereas TT, the purity may not be more than 80%. And safety, since this is a naturally detoxified protein, so it is of better safety compared to the TT and other toxoids. And regarding immunogenicity, compared to TT, this induces less carrier-induced immune suppression, especially when you use multiple polysaccharides meningococcal polysaccharides or pneumococcal polysaccharide vaccines. And also, since it is not, detoxified by using any chemicals, so the lysine components which are required for the conjugations are maximum and which are not blocked by the chemical toxicity. And this is a NMR spectroscopy showing the characterization of the CRM with more than 98% purity. And regarding the vaccine, so it contains VA polysaccharide 25 microgram. And here the specialty of this vaccine is this VA polysaccharide is derived from a non-pathogenic bacteria known as enterobacter fundi, which belongs to Enterobacteriaceae, which produces VA, which is immunologically indistinguishable to the VA of Salmonella typhi, which is confirmed both immunologically and chromatographically. What is Enterobacter fundi? In German, fundi means friend, because this bacteria lives in the animal and human, intestine, without causing disease in healthy people. And this bacteria, since it's involved in the maintenance of nitrogen cycle, it's called friend. And Citrobacter fundi advantage is in terms of vaccine manufacturing is this belongs to biosafety level 1, whereas the typhoid, Salmonella typhi, belongs to biosafety level 3. So in terms of manufacturing, safe manufacturing, this is a major advantage. Not only that, the amount of VA is almost double than the VA produced by the Salmonella typhi. And regarding the clinical title, so to declare that I was not part of either the designing or conduct or analysis of this data. So this is a multicenter single blind randomized controlled phase 2/3 study to evaluate immunogenicity and safety of a single intramuscular dose of B typhoid conjugate vaccine in healthy infant, children and adults in comparison with their licensed comparator And this is a comparator vaccine used was a Typhoid TCV manufactured by Bharat Biotech, and both contains VI polysaccharide 25 microgram, and whereas B contains CRM as a conjugate protein and Typhoid contains TT as a conjugate protein. Objective of this study was, the primary objective is to demonstrate non-inferiority of B's vaccine in terms of seroconversion rates at day 42 post-vaccination, and secondly was to evaluate the safety and tolerability of B's vaccine in comparison with the licensed TCV. And endpoints used were, primary endpoint, proportion of subjects with anti-VI IgG antibody titers above the threshold value of more than or equal to 2 microgram per ml and more than or equal to 4.3 microgram ml at day 42 post-vaccination, and proportion of subjects achieving more than or equivalent to 4-fold rise in anti-VI IgG titer at day 42, and geometric mean titers assessed by vaccine test. And secondary endpoints were the proportion of subjects with solicited and unsolicited adverse events during the 42-day follow-up period, and the proportion of subject with medically attended and serious adverse events.
2 minutes left.
Sorry, these are the study centers, and see, there were, the subjects were grouped out, say, subjects were like, say, it was a 1:1 randomization where group 1 contains 311, group 2 contains 311, and in the subgroup, 6 to 2 years, 2 years to 18 years and 18 years above, all the people received one dose, single intramuscular dose at the test of the comparison, and the blood sample were drawn at day 42. And regarding the seroconversion rate, and we have considered two like parameters for seroconversion rate. One is 2 microgram per ml and another one is 4.3 microgram ml, because the previous efficacy trials have shown that a value of 1.4 to 2 is one of the predictive value, it's a predictive value for the
efficacy, and also
any subject having antibody titer more than or equal to 4.3, it predicts almost a sustained protection for 4 years. So the non-inferiority parameter considered was, like, we calculate the proportion of subjects zero converted, then calculate the difference in the zero conversion rate with 95% confidence interval, the lower and the upper level, and if the lowest confidence interval is above the, say, minus 10% margin, then the non-inferiority is established. So here the lower confidence interval was minus 1.82, which is above minus 10. So the non-inferiority established. And this is the guideline for the WHO for 4.3 microgram per ml consideration. And here also, based on that, the non-inferiority was established because the lowest confidence interval was minus 3.87, which is well above minus 10. And regarding the subject with more than 4-fold rise in, both the vaccines showed similar 97%, and in the subgroups 96.2 in age group 6 to less than 2 years and 97.6 in more than 2 years. And in terms of the VI titers, both the vaccines have shown a very good titers, almost 1300 to 1400, whereas the minimum titer required for seroconversion threshold, that is 2 microgram, is equivalent to 113, and for the long term protection, which is more than 4.3, which is equivalent to
242.
And overall safety, both the vaccines resulted in similar safety. The number of subjects with at least one adverse event in B group was 8.6 versus 15.1, and the number of subjects with at least one medical attended adverse event was 2% in DETC and 4% in comparator. And this is the comparison of the local adverse events, and the pain was the most common reason. And this is the comparison of the systemic adverse events. And this result, like, this is the comparator,
like, vaccine results were similar to the one which seen in published trials.
Last slide. To summarize, say B vaccine was well tolerated in all age groups studied, and one serious adverse event in comparator group was observed as not associated with the vaccine. The number of subjects, at least one adverse event, was 8.4% in BETC versus 15% in
comparative TCE. This can be attributed to many factors like using the highly purified CRM197 and VA polysaccharide of many endo and exotoxins. And discussion.
The, as I told, showed high immunogenicity, which was not inferior to the comparator vaccine, both in terms of short term and long term.
Can you just tell us the conclusion, because we do.
Yeah, this is the last response. So non-inferiority was concluded both in short term and long term immunogenicity considered, and overall,
see, like frequency of adverse events, local and systemic, was similar to the comparator groups.